Hey guys, Hardware Junkies here. Today I'm going to be showing you how to connect your PlayStation 4 DualShock 4 controller to your PC. It's actually pretty easy, but first we have to install a few things on your system. To start, you're going to want to go down to the links I have listed below this video, and you're going to want to install the Xbox 360 controller drivers. What this is actually going to do is it's going to trick your computer into thinking you have an Xbox 360 controller plugged in, when in all reality we actually have the PlayStation controller plugged in. To start, you're going to want to select your operating system. Windows 7 will also work for Windows 8. So for me, I'm running a 64-bit system, so I'm going to click that. And then you're just going to hit download. And you're going to save it. And open it up. You'll hit yes. And I already have it installed, so I'm not going to go through the installation process again, but just go right through and that'll be all set up. Next, you're going to want to make sure you have the latest DirectX installed on your system. So you'd hit download for that. You're also gonna want Microsoft Net Framework 4 installed. So make sure you have that installed. If you do not, download that from the links below. And you're also gonna want to make sure you have the latest Visual C++ from 2012, and you'll download that. After you have all that downloaded, you're gonna want to go to the following link below, and it'll take you to this website. You want to scroll down to the latest update and click here to download the latest software. After you're on this website, you're going to scroll down to the download part. Click that. I already have this installed in a different folder, but I'm going to save it here anyway. You're going to click it. Yes. And you're going to run that. I want to cancel that so that I don't reinstall it since I already have it. And you're probably going to have a window here that'll say install, and just go through the installation process and get that all installed. Now, once you have that all installed, you're going to want to go in and open DS4 Windows. That might automatically open depending on how you have it installed. And once you're here, you're going to want to take your PlayStation 4 controller and plug it into your system, like I'm about to do. And once you have that plugged in, it should pop up right here on the screen, as you can see. And it'll be having default settings. If you want to change the settings, you can click that down arrow and edit profile. Here you can assign different buttons to do different jobs. So you can set it all different mappings, configurations, and you could just play around with these settings to your own liking. And once you finish setting up all of your settings, you can actually even use your touchpad on the controller as a mouse cursor. So once that's all done, you can go ahead, open up your favorite game, and you are ready to start playing. When you are ready to shut down the program, you can just hit X, and it'll say quitting this application will cause controllers to stop functioning. Are you sure? And you'll hit yes, and that'll all shut right down.